This is THG News Today on THG Network. My name is Mervyn Hanley. What do the influencers say? Welcome to my channel. How are you doing? Welcome to THG Network. It's a beautiful morning. It's the beginning of September. Well, we are at the third day in on September, so I hope that your September started off well. It was a holiday yesterday, Labor Day, in the United States, so I took that day off, but here I am today with THG News Today, powered by Carl & Son's Unique Bakery on St. Martin, with three locations on the island, and Feezer's on Nevis, along with Hanley's Plumbing Service. If you have not subscribed, of course, we always ask that you subscribe to our channel. If you've been here before and you have not, I'm just giving you a reminder. If this is your first time, well, I hope that you would do just that so that you can be kept abreast on what's happening. So let's begin with our news this morning. We'll begin with news out of Antigua. Prime Minister the Honorable Gaston Browne expressed deep concern over the growing issue of youth unemployment and the increasing tendency of young people to engage in criminal activities. Speaking on Point FM on Saturday, the Prime Minister highlighted the challenges faced by young people who have dropped out of school and are seeking employment without the necessary qualifications. According to Prime Minister Browne, many young people approach him seeking jobs but are unwilling to accept positions that match their skill levels. You want a job at the port? Okay, there's a vacancy for a mechanic. And the Prime Minister will then say to them, you can make $1,800 a month, Browne said, recounting his conversations with young people. However, he noted that many reject such opportunities, demanding higher paying jobs despite lacking the qualifications. According to Prime Minister Browne, some of them come and tell you they don't want a $3,000 job unless they get a $5,000 job. They don't want to work, Browne remarked, emphasizing the unrealistic expectations held by some of our young people. The Prime Minister also drew attention to the consequences of these attitudes, noting that many of these youths end up turning to illegal activities such as drug dealing, which often leads to their involvement in crime and violence. They end up pushing marijuana. They end up in crime and violence. They end up in jail, he said. Browne expressed his frustration with the situation, pointing out that the problem is not new and is not limited to any specific community. He recalled a time in the early 2000s when he and others were taken to court for speaking out at a Labor Day event, during which he observed a disturbing trend among young men coming in and out of the courtroom for various offenses. We saw a whole slew of young people coming in and out of court, bad, wicked young men, he said, echoing the concerns raised by a colleague at the time who predicted that these young men would pose a significant problem for society in the future. The Prime Minister stressed the need for urgent action to address these issues, calling for more efforts to educate and reform young people. He acknowledged that many young people today are focused on making quick money, often without regard for how they obtain it. It's about money, and they don't care how they get it, just get them the money, Browne warned, noting that similar sentiments may be found among other groups in society. And he's correct. Nowadays, if they want a new cell phone, the latest, they will find the money to get it. If they want a weave, some of those weaves cost like $1,000 and $1,200, they will find a means to get it. And young people, and now high maintenance. They are just high maintenance, I'm telling you. Yeah, so... But it's a serious concern for the Prime Minister of Antigua and Barbuda, and I'm sure not just in Antigua and Barbuda, but it's a trend around the Caribbean. And as he stated something here, and it is so true, when you tell them about a job that pays $1,800 a month, according to him, for a mechanic, they're telling you, no, we don't want it. They don't have the qualifications for anything higher, mind you, but they're telling you, we want $5,000, or pay us $5,000 for that job that is paying $1,800. And that's our young people today, and I'm telling you, this next generation coming up, I don't know. But let's continue with the news. The United States has seized Venezuela President Nicolas Maduro's airplane after determining that its acquisition was in violation of U.S. sanctions, among other criminal issues. The U.S. flew the aircraft to Florida on Monday, according to two U.S. officials. It's the latest development in what has long been a frosty relationship between the United States and Venezuela and its seizure in the Dominican Republic. This marks an escalation as the U.S. continues to investigate what it regards as corrupt practices by Venezuelan government. The plane has been described by officials as Venezuela's equivalent to Air Force One, and it has been pictured in previous state visits by Maduro around the world. This sends a message all the way to the top, one of the U.S. officials told CNN. Seizing the foreign head of state's airplane is unheard of for criminal matters. We're sending a clear message here that no one is above the law. No one is above the reach of U.S. sanctions. Yeah? So that's the latest tensions again between Venezuela and the U.S. and Venezuela. They had an election there that was totally fraud. And of course, the U.S. is not standing for it. So you will find that there will be a number of sanctions and number of acts such as this one and more regarding Maduro. I won't be surprised if in the coming weeks or months, we'll wake up one morning and either, sorry to say, he will either be dead, Maduro, or the U.S. will find a way to get him out of Venezuela or whatever the case may be. So we'll hear that. It's going to happen. It's inevitable. And finally, in our news this morning, 5 people were shot near the West Indian American Day Parade in Brooklyn, what we call Labor Day Parade in Brooklyn, on Monday afternoon, police said. The shooting happened along the en route of the parade on Eastern Parkway near Franklin Avenue in Crown Heights, according to the NYPD. A man walked up to the crowd and started shooting, police said. It's unclear what led to the shooting, but police said it wasn't random. This was an intentional act by one person toward a group of people, the NYPD Chief of Parole John Chell said. We do not by no means have any active shooter or anything of that nature running around Eastern Parkway as we speak. 4 men and a woman were shot, police said. All 5 victims are expected to survive, according to police. The victims range in age from 16 to 69 years old. The shooter has not been arrested. The West Indian American Day Parade, an annual carnival celebration of Caribbean culture and pride, was held in Brooklyn on Monday. The parade started off at the Schenectady Avenue and ended at Grand Army Plaza. Yes, every year is something with these shootings at the West Indian Day Parade, so this is not surprising, but yet sad and unfortunate. With that, we've just concluded THG News for today, Tuesday, September 3rd. We'll be back with you tomorrow, God's willing, at the same time for a similar presentation. My name is Mervyn Hanley. Again, the news was powered by Carl & Son's Unique Bakery on St. Martin, Hanley's Plumbing on Nevis, along with Feces on Nevis. Have yourselves a wonderful day.
Carl & Sons have been serving the people of St. Martin for over 40 years. And the food and service get better and better. From early morning, customers flock to the bakery for their favorite sandwiches, cakes, pastries, you name it. First thing at mornings and last thing at afternoons, folks rush to Carl & Sons for simply the best. There are 2 locations, Cold Bay and on the Pondville. In Cold Bay, the opening hours are Monday to Friday from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. On Saturdays, 6 a.m. to 5 p.m. And on Sundays, 6:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. and 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. Opening hours on the Pondville, Monday to Friday, 6:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Saturday and Sunday, 6:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. We also cater for weddings, parties, special events, whatever the occasion. It's Carl & Sons. Our staff, we are always happy to serve you. Call us today, the Cold Bay location, 721-544-2462. That's 721-544-2462. Or in Phillipsburg, 721-543-1059. That's 721-543-1059. It's Carl & Sons Bakery. We are here to serve you.
Nevis, satisfy your sweet tooth at Feces, the coziest spot in Charlestown, known for its mouth-watering ice cream and dalpery. We are open Monday to Saturday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Come in and sample our patties, sandwiches, air-fried wings with fries, hot dogs, rotis, and now our famous smoothies, in all flavors, of course. And don't forget to try the famous bossop shot and saltfish. It's Feces, located at the entrance to the Cotton Ginnery Mall in Charlestown, Nevis. They're also available by phone, so place your order by calling 1-869-665-2458. Don't ask about the rest, just try the best.